Freed-Hardeman University and Gulf Coast State College welcomes all players, officials, and spectators to the Battle at the Beach for a matchup between the Freed-Hardeman Lions and the Southwestern Assemblies of God Lions. The Southern States Athletic Conference and the NAIA are committed to promoting an environment of inclusion that is character-driven and embracing of the culture of its diverse institutions. The NAIA empowers student athletes, coaches, officials, and fans to demonstrate at all times our champions of character five core values of integrity, respect, responsibility, sportsmanship, and servant leadership, which create a positive and competitive environment. Now, for the starting lineup, starting with the visitors on the scoreboard, Freed-Hardeman.
What a welcome you live to the Billy Harrison Fieldhouse here in the campus of Gulf State College, Panama City Beach, Florida. A dreary, rainy kind of a day, but that don't matter. It's 72 degrees inside the Billy Harrison Fieldhouse at basically all times, and that makes our job pretty easy. So, Freed-Hardeman taking on Southwestern Assemblies of God University, or from here forward, SAGU. Again, I will go back and say, I think you're missing a massive branding opportunity by skipping Swag U. Print the t-shirts, print the hats, print the money. You're welcome. I'm just saying. All right. Jeremy Smith alongside David Turner here as the Lions of Freed-Hardeman and the Lions of SAGU. All right, so we're done with Lions, for the rest
now.
Of the day.
Anything else we can eliminate?
That's right. So FHU and SAGU, 5-1 overall is Freed-Hardeman coming into this one, in SAGU at 3-2 overall. And, of course, SAGU coming off of the downside of the moment of the tournament so far, which was the 23-point come-from-behind win by Florida College yesterday that ended in absolute dramatic fashion. So, SAGU looking to recover, having dropped two straight by a total of 3 points. Looking to recover against the number 8 team in the country in Freed-Hardeman. We got a top 25 matchup with 8 versus 22 here. The starters first for the Lions of Freed-Hardeman in the maroon. Number 0, 6'1 sophomore guard out of Bolivar, Tennessee, Quan Lax. Number 1, a 6-foot sophomore guard out of Clarksville, Tennessee, J.J. Wheat. Number 2, 6'7 sophomore forward out of Calhoun, Georgia, Peyton Law. Number 3, 6'7 senior forward out of Nashville, Tennessee, Hunter Skerlock. And number 33, 6'6 junior forward out of Kansas City, Missouri, Devin Tomlinson. The starters for SAGU, David Turner.
Number 1, Illyric Hall, a 5'9 junior guard from Mansfield, Texas. Number 2, C.J. Hall, a 6'2 junior guard from Mansfield, Texas. Number 3, Noah Bowling, he is a graduate guard, 5'10 from Ballastine, Texas. Number 4, C.J. Kelly, he's a 6'9 junior forward from Texarkana, Texas. And finally, number 5, J.J. Bowling, the 6'6 sophomore forward from Van Alstine, Texas.
So two sets of brothers in the starting lineup for SAGU, and the Hull brothers and the Bowling brothers. 19:42 remaining on the clock here. As the ball thrown into Skerlock, he worked it over to Tomlinson. Now down in the corner, that's going to be Wheat with it. Fires it ahead. Hunter Skerlock off the glass, no good. Rebound taken down by J.J. Bowling. And we'll go the other way with it. Bowling works it over to the left side to Noah Bowling. Back over Hall, and Hall again. Bowling. Right side, Bowling for 3. J.J. Bowling buries it. Working over the timeline. Back over the screen of Tomlinson, all the way to the rack, won't go. Rebound Bowling, throw out C.J. Hawley at 32 yesterday. Step back on the fade, won't drop. Rebound, Freed-Hardeman going the other way. Thrown ahead, that's Law. Law works it up. Off the screen. Layup, right hand, no good. Rebound taken down, going the other way. Over the timeline it is.
Hall to Hall.
Good feet inside.
Ahead to Kelly, and he softly ducks it home.
Good vision by Hall. Just that quick bounce pass inside right to Kelly.
Hall throwing ahead. Skerlock now. Tomlinson works it over left side. Back up Skerlock now right side. Working over. Lax to Wheat to Skerlock. Good move. And he's called for the travel though. It's too good of a move.
A 2-2-1 look from Freed-Hardeman here defensively. Trying to slow the Sagu team from the pace that they like to play with.
Hall working to the left. Back over the screen of Kelly. Back into the hand of C.J. Hall now. Hall bowling three. Noah bowling for three. How about the bowling brothers with a pair of threes? And it's a 5-3 lead. Or an 8-0 lead, apologies. I was looking at two things at one time.
Quick start for Sagoon. And a struggle here for Freed-Hardeman. 0-3 from the floor. No, nothing really open for them that they're taking. Every time they try to get inside with it, they've been met at the rim and turned away.
Ball will be inbounded by Skerlock. Looking over the timeline is Wheat. Looks it left. Tomlinson. Over the timeline, Skerlock. Back out to Law. Skerlock, three. No, left short. We've been taking that down the other way. C.J. Hall throws it ahead. Kelly can't catch it. Over the timeline. Law. Tomlinson. Layup right hand.
Block.
No good. And a blocking foul on J.J. Bowler.
Skerlock to the free throw line. 63% so far on the season.
Skerlock makes the first one. So Freed-Hardeman's on the board. That'll cut it to 8-1. That one misses front iron, no good. Kelly, the rebound going the other way. There's Hall. Left side. Fires it down. There's the attack. The jumper out of the corner, no good. Tip alive. C.J. Hall the board. Hall works over to J.J. Bowling. Hand off. Noah Bowling. Turn the corner, feeds it back out. Alaric Hall all the way through, and a feed to Kelly, but a foul. So fouls on Quan Lax. Into the corner, Noah Bowling, three, off target, rebound taken out, C.J. Kelly, can't control it, out of bounds off Freed-Hardeman.
That's good action on that inbound play to get Bowling a clean look in the corner. Brought him low up around baseline off a screen, all the way back around to that baseline corner.
Thrown in, corralled by Kelly. There's Alaric Hall. Back over to Noah Bowling. Throws it away. C.J. Hall tries to save it. Noah Bowling's got it. Six to shoot. Five to shoot as he drives, pulls. Front iron no good. Tipped out. Skurlock's got it. Skurlock works it over. There's the drive all the way to the block, up off the glass, and good. Laquan Lyons. First field goal of the game for the Lions of Freed-Hardeman. Derek Hall works it over, and a layup by the right hand of J.J. Bowling.
Good find by Lyric Hall. Had Bowling right there, just lobs it up to him. Nobody around him, able to lay it up and in easily.
Lax working off the screen. Tomlinson. Right side. There's the drive, step through. Front iron, no good. Tip back up and good by J.J. Wheat. Or by Quan Lax, correction. 10-5 it is. Working left, Skurlock with steal. Gives it up to Tomlinson. Back out, it's Lax to Wheat. Tomlinson, Skurlock, nice finish. And a good find by Tomlinson.
Good find up top, a great seal inside by Skurlock. Got the man back, opened up the passing lane and caught it cleanly and was able to get an easy bucket.
Alaric Hall on the deck with it. Up off the front iron, no good. Rebound taking that, going the other way. That gets it ahead. There's the drive by Weed up off the glass, off the rim, but he's fouled. Second foul, number three, Noah Bowling. 10-7 is the score. A quick timeout here, 30-second timeout by Sagu. Sagu. They've already gotten 10 shots off from the floor. 7 rebounds for them. And they've shared the basketball well. 4 assists and all 4 made baskets. Kylan Owens and Justin Collins will check in. C.J. Kelly and Noah Bowling check out for Sagu. Sam Powell, Phil Horton in the ball game. Hunter Skurlock, Devin Tomlinson out for Freed-Hardeman. Free throw up and good for J.J. Wheat.
Wheat, the leading scorer for Freed-Hardeman, averaging 13.8 coming into this afternoon. Knocks the second one home.
10-9 is the lead for Sagu. Ball thrown ahead, that's caught. There's the drive, back over for Collins. Collins got it to Bowling, splits two defenders on the step through, caught him at the feed. Now poked out from behind. Freed-Hardeman will keep the basketball. Horton comes off the bench and immediately gets a steal. It's basically what he did yesterday. There's Horton over to the left side now. Geraldo Lane also in the ballgame for Freed-Hardeman. Peyton Law for three. No. Bowling the board out to Alaric Hall. Back to Bowling for three. No. Get a foul underneath.
And going Law of Freed-Hardeman.
Collins will inbound it. Collected and thrown off of Geraldo Lane. T.J. Hall making plays, even on little things like that. Ball thrown into Collins. Works off the screen, downhill, and a foul.
Sam Powell of Freed-Hardeman. Third team foul for Freed-Hardeman.
Fired in. Stolen by Law, so Freed-Hardeman going to come away with a steal. Horton got it out. Up top now, Law, or rather Powell. Deep three, knocked down by Geraldo Lane. Freed-Hardeman with its first lead at 12-10. Working off the screen. Hall and Owens. There's Collins. Bowling. Hall. Owens. Alaric Hall. Back out. Kicks it over. Ball fake. Got his man in the air. Now didn't get his hand out of his hand in time. So shot clock violation.
Noah Bowling back into the ball game for Sagu. J.J. Bowling will take a seat.
Lax with it over the timeline. Has a screen if he wants it. He goes the other way to Peyton Law. Now back up to Powell. Swung it over Lane. Dumped it down to Horton. Horton pulls the mid-range. Good. Good. 12:25 remaining in this opening half. And Alaric Call over the timeline, off the screen from Owens to the elbow. Fires it up and stolen. Just had Owens fronted in the post and was he found it easy to catch that pass to start that break. Now the finish at the other end.
Sam Powell on the finish. Good pass inside. And one opportunity for Powell now at the free throw line.
Already four steals for Freed-Hardeman in this ballgame.
Freed-Hardeman on the season, a team that averages about 10.5 steals per game. So they want to disrupt your ball handlers and make it difficult for them.
That one knocked through by Powell. 17-10, Freed-Hardeman leads. C.J. Kelly returns, Kylan Owens checks out.
As you look at it, this was a game that was 8-0 for Sagu, 17-2 run from that point forward.
Next stop is to get us to the under-12 media. Collins the drive, back out of Larry Cox. There's Bowling, left, right in, won't go, tip in, won't go. Kelly got his own rebound, put back, won't go, but a foul, he'll go to the line. Kelly just busted it on the boards.
C.J. Kelly, 71% from the free throw line. And that is going to, we're going to kick that to the media. This is the Faulkner Sports Network presentation of The Battle at the Beach.
17-10 is the score. Free throw up and good for C.J. Kelly. One more coming for Kelly. Knocks it home. Ball thrown in. Over the timeline. Fired ahead. It's Lane. Left side. Ducked down. Back out. No good. Rebound going the other way. That's Bowling on the right wing there. Feeds it over. C.J. Hall. Left hand layup. Good.
Good cut, C.J. Hall coming from the wing. Good find, lays it up and in, closes this gap to three.
Bench warning on Sagu. Lane inbounds at the Horton. Powell, Wheat, Horton, Law, Powell, three, no, Lane, or Horton the rebound, put back up, no, tipped out, corralled and now headed the other way. C.J. Hall, three-point deficit, into the paint, feeds it, and nope, now pulls it from the free throw line, good. Oh. Horton got it over. Now over the timeline. Wheat feeds it out to Long. There's Lane, Powell, Horton.
Good pass.
And Wheat with a tough finish. Change to the left hand. Up and around and through. Scoops it in. There's the bench warning for Freed-Hardeman. For Freed-Hardeman, they've got two coaches who use a dry erase board and draw sets and plays or whatever the call is. And they write it on that dry erase board and they stand up and show it off. And that was the bench warning that they're not allowed to stand up. So I'm just curious, from a rules standpoint, is Bowling with a three through the contact that ties the game. Just curious from a rules standpoint, if you can put those two guys behind the bench,
right,
like in the bleachers, and tell him to stand up
right
over there. There's the drive, not loose. And a blocking foul.
Couple of Sagu defenders there to choose from. Looks like they're going to go with Kelly.
That's the first on Kelly. Ball thrown into Tomlinson. Floats it up. Back out, no good. And a foul.
Charge. You get Skurlock, the offensive foul, going after the rebound.
Yeah. Skurlock with the foul. Working is Bowling. Got it down to the corner now. Working out of there is Collins. Eight to shoot. Step back three. Bam. Collins with his first three of the ballgame. Four out of seven from deep right now.
for Sagu. They're up by three. Tomlinson, Nalane, Scarlock, Wheat, Tomlinson again. Back up under, won't drop, can't get the board. It's cleared out of there by Jonker. Noah Jonker, his first appearance in this ball game. Deep three, no good. I'm going to call that a heat check three for Bowling.
Yeah, Bowling, 2 of 4 from beyond the arc, or 2 of 3 before that one, now 2 of 4. Has to be exactly what that was, because it was not the best look, cleanest look that was available at the time.
Skirla working right side, got it fed down in the corner, grab baseline, now back out. Wheat leaves it, Skirla. Foul going to be called on Jonker. I called Weed a moment ago. It's actually lax. Apologies on that drive. 15 foul. Both teams with 5. Thrown in, thrown away. Bowling will start the break after he picks it up. Floats up, and his brother can't catch it. They were looking Bowling to Bowling for the finish there. Just couldn't connect. Twenty-2-19, 8 minutes remaining in the first half. Freed-Hardeman with the ball and the deficit. Attacks right down the teeth of the defense, no good. Rebound, Skirlock up off the glass, good.
Good job by Skirlock going right back up with it, not giving defense time to set up and adjust to that offensive rebound.
1 point game.
Call is going to go against Sagu. That is going to be on Jonker again.
22-21, 7:36 remaining in the opening half, and Jonker with his second foul. 16 foul on Sagu, one more, and we're to the bonus. I would consider it a bonus if nobody got to the bonus.
Agreed.
Working left, down into the paint, back out. Tomlinson works out of the corner. Long pass, 9 to shoot as Lane catches. 7-6-5, and Skirlock for 3, no good. Tomlinson the board and the reset. Lax pulls it. No. Rebound cleared by Kelly. He runs into Skirlock, loses the ball out of bounds off Skirlock. Collins over the line. Poked out off of Collins. Tomlinson won't get credited with a steal, but he absolutely created that.
That's great hands by Tomlinson just to tip that ball away and off of the Sagu player.
Disrupted. There's Skirlock. Tomlinson. Fed back to Tomlinson. Nice move underneath on the power dribble, and he finishes.
It's a good set all the way around. Kick it over to the lane, or to the wing, rather. Curl Tomlinson down to the post. Good pass inside. Rewarded with it with a good, clean finish.
Looking left. Almost lost it. Regathered. Hall to Bowling. The Bowling. The three. In and out. Tipped alive. Skirlock's got it. Numbers for Freed-Hardeman. Tomlinson for 3. No. Rebound Law. Back up. No. Rebound Kelly. Sagu going the other way down 1. Bowling with it. Jonker has it stolen. The drive all the way to the rack. Layout right hand good. And a 3-point lead. Hall. Bowling. Bowling to Hall. Find the shoot. Downhill, kick out, Jonker, barrel. End of the shot clock, and he ties the ball game. Next stop is with the under six media, except this one. This is actually a timeout, 30-second timeout. We'll keep it here. Freed-Hardeman 40% from the floor so far. Sagu 45%.
Big thing for Sagu, 5 of 10 from 3, shooting the ball well from beyond the three-point line here, and that's been a big factor for them in this first half to this point.
Yeah, it's helped them overcome 8 turnovers and the 14-6 advantage for Freed in points off turnovers. Conversely, Freed just 1 of 7 from beyond the arc. But you look at some of those ancillary categories, and they're not going Sagu's way.
They're not.
But the three-point line has kept them in it and has allowed them to stay even.
And look, if you can keep that going for a period of time and correct those other numbers and even them out a little bit, this is very much a ball game that they want to be in.
25 all, 5:08 remaining in the first half. Next dead ball will be the media. Working off the screen. Black's got it back out, lost, step through, got it to go. So Peyton Law with his first bucket of the day and freed up two. Eric Collin and Noah Bowling attacks downhill, feeds it ahead. Kicks back out. J.J. Bowling for three. No good. Noah Bowling rebound. Put back. No. Law the ball. There's Law. Horton. Skurlock. Kicks it out. Law right back underneath to the block and laid up by Quan Lax.
Great quick pass from Law up top. Recognized the flash open there on the block on the right side. Just rips it right back in there.
Working right. The attack into the paint. Turn around at the elbow. Back out. Bowling off his spot. Misses. Law chases it down. Thrown ahead to Skurlock. Back over. Attacks all the way. Low. Couldn't get the scoop to drop. But a foul, that's going to get us to the under six media. Hey, if you're out there, you want to let us know, email us fsn@partner.edu, fsn@partner.edu. Tell us who you are, who you're watching for, where you're watching from. Back in a moment at the Battle of the Beach. .9-25, Freed-Hardeman with the lead and at the free throw line. First one is missed by Geraldo Lane. One more coming. Made the second.
30-25, Freed-Hardeman leads. Saget with basketball. Left side, Alaric Hall. Bowling. Worked it down to the corner. And a whistle. They're going to get Horton, it looks like. So a foul on Horton. Email comes in from Chrissy Tomlinson. Says, hey there, watching from Kansas City, Missouri. Good luck, FHU. Let's go, Mo, number 33. Thank you again for showing this for us. And great to hear from you, Miss Chrissy Tomlinson. Her son's team up 30-27 right now, and for that C.J. Hall layout. Horton ahead to Wheat. Works down toward the block and back out. Lane in the lane, kicks it. Skurlock hesitated. Threw himself off rhythm a little bit. Bowling to Hall. Throws it over the top to Owen. Owen's trap. Back to Jonker, deflected. Skurlock with it, going the other way. All the way in, layup, right hand won't drop. Fight for the ball, Skurlock wins it, lays it up off the glass. He's got 7. A lot of what we saw yesterday out of Freed-Hardeman, everybody has scored. Balance aplenty. Foul on J.J. Wheat. Free throw from Owen. It's no good.
Owens hadn't been there a ton this year, but to that point was perfect on the season from the free throw line.
Makes the second, misses the first. Working over the timeline momentarily. There he is, off the screen of Horton. And a hand check.
Foul on C.J. Hall.
That's the second on Hall. 8th team foul against Sagu. It's a 1-1 here. Missed it. Rebound taken and Jonker going the other way. Hall fires it ahead. Kelly back over to C.J. Hall. Backs it out. Looks to turn the corner. Blocked by Peyton Law and a foul call.
Great defense by Peyton Law and Hall on that drive.
Gonna be 1-1 here. They put it on Skurlock. Email comes in from Shelly Kaiser. Says, let's go, Sagu. Watching from Iowa again today for the Bowling family. Thank you again for your filming and commentating. Blessed Thanksgiving to you and yours. Great to hear from you, Shelly. Thank you so much for your kind words and your encouragement. CJ Kelly, free throw up and good. 32-29 now, Sagu trails. Kelly with 5 points on the ledger. Trying to add one more here. It's good. So, 32-30. Ball thrown into Wheat. Gets it out to Skurlock. Lane. Horton. Working back, Law, Lane. Now out up top, back over Horton to Skurlock, 4 to shoot. Skurlock got it to go.
Pretty drive by Skurlock, spins right to the basket. Shot over the longer defender.
34-30. Defense. 108 to play.
Collins the handoff. Bowling out of the corner. Five to shoot. Jonker. Alaric Hall. Jonker. Escape dribble. Can't get it to go. Law the rebound. Over the timeline. There's Law. Horton. Law. Off the screen is Wheat. 31 and counting in the half. 9 on the shot clock right now. Skerlock. Turn around at the elbow. No good. Rebound Kelly. Shot clock's off. 16 to go in the half. Eric Hall will slow things down. He drives, feeds, Collins. J.J. Bowling, Barry! 1-point game as we go to half. Back in 15 minutes from Battle Beach.
Hey!
Back here line, Billy Harrison Fieldhouse, campus of Gulf Coast State College. Panama City Beach, Florida. It's been a good one. Number 8 in the country, Freed-Hardeman, 34. Number 22 in the country, Southwestern Assemblies of God, 33. 43.8% from the floor for Freed-Hardeman in the first half. 40.7% from the floor for Sagu. And again, big difference, three-point line. 6 out of 13 for Sagu. 1 out of 8 for Freed. That's allowed to Sagu to stay in this ballgame. There's a three off target from J.J. Bowling. Rebound, taking it out, going the other way is J.J. Wheat. Skerlock, Law, Wheat. That's a 2. No. Tomlinson the board. Power dribble back up. Got it to go. Bowling right side, C.J. Hall. Noah Bowling. Left side of Eric Hall, throws it to the elbow. C.J. Kelly no good. Rebound taken down, going the other way. There's Skerlock. Law. Skerlock again, now works it over to Lax. Skerlock down in the corner, that's Wheat. Wheat back toward the baseline now. Tomlinson on the left wing with 11 to shoot, fires it ahead, deflected and stolen. No Bowling will lead the break.
Good
finds
feed.
C.J. Hall. That's where he's so lethal, yeah, is in transition. He had 6 points in the first half, hadn't really gotten going. We saw him have 32 yesterday.
And 25 of that in the first half where he had that explosion of getting buckets just like that.
Skerlock to Law. Works it over to Wheat. Now back up. There's Skerlock, top of the key. Nearly lost it. Law into the corner. There's Lax on the drive. Dumps it over to Skerlock. Up with it. Left hand. Climbs over but won't drive. C.J. Kelly with it. Back the other way, Alaric Hall now. Feeds it back over right side. Noah Bowling, ball fake, puts it on the deck, split two defenders, and a hand check. Slow him down, take him back. And a foul on J.J. Wheat.
Second foul on Wheat.
There's Alaric Hall with it. J.J. Bowling, now Noah Bowling. Bounce pass over C.J. Kelly, flips it to C.J. Hall. The drive, the pull, got it to go. He's in double figures at 10, the first player to double figures in the ballgame. 37-36, Sagu leads.
Oh.
And a blocking foul on Alaric Hall. It's his first personal.
It's a block or a carry, either one. Late whistle.
Email comes in from Michael Mullenix, the voice of Freed-Hardeman basketball. Says great basketball this week, especially in that first half. Can't wait to see more in the second. Go Lions. Good to hear from you, Michael. Get you out there. You want to let us know? Email us FSN at Faulkner.edu. The drive off the glass, and it drops. J.J. Wheat gets it to go. Email us FSN at Faulkner.edu and tell us how much you like that C.J. Kelly James. Tell us who you are, who you're watching for, and where you're watching from. FSN at Faulkner.edu. There's Law. Back over to Tomlinson, now down in the corner to Wheat. Worked it ahead to Skerlock off the glass and good. Styles make fights, David Turner, and this has been a good one.
It has been, and the Sagu team was averaging about 94 points per game coming into this and held right now to 39. So the defensive pressure from Freed-Hardeman doing its job, but you see how potent they can be once they get out on the fast break.
And their ability to fill it up from beyond the arc. Again, incredibly impressive, shooting just under 43% today. They're shooting 44% on the season from beyond the arc. There's a foul away from the ball. It's on.
Fouling Peyton Law.
Peyton Law, gotcha. That's his second. That's the second team foul on Freed-Hardeman this half. Noah Bowling to inbound. Going to get another foul on Peyton Law. Two quick ones on him here, and he's got three. So they're going to come get Law. Geraldo Lane checking in. Ball thrown into Alaric Hall. Works left. The drive and a foul. Three defensive fouls called here on this one possession over the course of about, 6 seconds of actual clock time.
That one on Tomlinson, that's two for him.
Now what do we get? And a tech. Wow. Three personals and now a tech on Freed in the last 8 seconds. So Noah Bowling to go to the line. Woo! Getting a little chippy down here at the beach. 40-39, Bowling to the line, and he ties the ball game. One more coming from Noah Bowling, who now has seven. Makes that one.
Freed-Hardeman, 30-second timeout.
30-second timeout by Freed. Really smart here to kind of settle things again. Three personals and a tech in 8 seconds.
Actually, it looks like they're going to stretch it to a full, but... yeah, this is a good time to kind of get some composure back among your players, get them out of that frustrated state, allow them to kind of move on, put that behind them.
And for the rest of us here to actually start the clock moving.
Yes,
email
please.
Comes in from our buddy Dustin Seymour. SID Freed-Hardeman. He said, SID nervously watching. I had a 4-team tournament this Saturday. Bless you for your 400-team tournament this weekend. So great to hear from Dustin. And apparently the phrasing that drew the tech was the complaint about there being three consecutive personal fouls in that span. So they went ahead and issued a tech, made it four fouls. The petty is strong in that one. So, yeah, there does seem to be an inordinate amount of techs that have been called in this event this weekend as well. So, and 5 seconds, couldn't get the ball in. So, 8 seconds of the clock moving results in three personals and a tech.
And a turnover.
And the ball, like, never good getting
back
inbounded.
Court. Back cut.
Hey, up the right hand. That was the weirdest sequence down the floor I've ever seen. Three personals, a tech, the clock barely moves, and the ball never gets inbounded. All right, 42-41. Freed-Hardeman thrown down to Kelly, and we're going to get a whistle. Okay. A blood issue for J.J. Bowling. So he's got to check out and get that dealt with.
42-41, 16-12 remaining. Bowling dealing with the blood as Shusa Collins back in the ballgame. Thrown in and stolen, and he stepped on the line. Good effort there, but couldn't control it. For J.J. Wheat there. Ball thrown into Kelly. Hand off Collins. Collins works it right. Hall to Hall. Spins into the lane, pulls it free throw line, and smooth. From C.J. Hall, he's got 12. You made a comparison yesterday comparing the offensive game of C.J. Hall to that of Kyrie Irving, and I think that's about as good of a comparison as I've seen.
Just as smooth as he is on the basketball, he can get wherever he wants to go within the matter of a couple of dribbles, and ball tapped out, and it's going to be Freed-Hardeman basketball.
More importantly, now, Geraldo Lane is hurt. Noah Bowling not feeling too good either. They may have knocked knees or something. But Lane having a hard time getting up. He'll walk to the other end of the floor, limping all the way. Ball thrown in, C.J. Hall. Back to Noah Bowling. Right side, there's the attack downhill. Spins it back out. Noah Bowling, no. Rebound, Kelly. Thrown back out, poked loose. Loose ball, Geraldo Lane lays it up, and it won't drop in a foul. Man, oh man, 15-17 to go, and every sequence feels pivotal right now for these two teams in terms of their urgency and their intensity levels. Free throw. Try to tie this ball game here. As Lane gets another look at it. Got it.
Paul with the basketball working on Skirling. Shot is up.
Rebound, and now Noah Bowling is down. He's able to get back up, but he's trailing the play. C.J. Kelly blocks it. No Bowling can't continue. He just drops as they're back in transition the other way. No Bowling's going to have to check out. He'll be replaced by Noah Jonker. Still, look, it's the little things that announcers pay attention to. You got two sets of brothers in the starting lineup for Sagu, Hall, Bowling, Bowling.
And Noah was just substituted for Noah.
You also have two CJs in the starting lineup, Hall and Kelly. And now you just subbed a Noah for another Noah. So there's a lot of symmetry. Ball fired back over to Noah Jonker. Turns the corner, gets it back over. That's Alaric Hall. Flips it over the top to CJ Kelly. Up off the glass and a foul. So in a tie ball game, 14-32. That is a foul called on Quan Lax. That's the sixth team foul against Freed, and we're not even 6 minutes into this second half. That one knocked down by Kelly. 1 point lead for Sagu.
Kelly, the 70% free throw shooter on the season, knocks the second one home as well.
Makes that one. 45-43. Ball thrown over. Skerlock over the timeline, gets it over right side. That's now to the left to Skerlock again. Now down to Wheats. Back out, Lux, three, off target. Skerlock can't get it, Kelly takes it. Alaric Hall going the other way. He spins, ball. Ripped clean by J.J. Wheat. Wheat threw up, offensive foul. Jonker had bought the land and can show you the deed. Good job by Noah Jonker getting there, planting his feet right outside that circle and holding.
Yeah, really made that one an easy call for the referee. Just pushed a little too much there on the offensive end in transition for Wheat.
C.J. Hall works it over to Collins. Collins over the timeline. Dogged by Wheat. Working now is C.J. Hall. Back over the top, Jonker, Collins. Lost it, regathered it. Deflected, Alaric Hall for three. In and out at the shot clock. And Skerlock can't control the board. And now Freed's got to defend for another 30.
It'll be 30, or will they reset it to 20? Because
yeah, it'll be
Skerlock.
20. Correction, yeah, Skerlock never had possession of it. Ball will be thrown in by Collins. And a
blocking foul on a screen on Jonker.
Jonker picks up the foul.
Frustrating sequence. You pick up the extra possession and then lose it just that quickly.
Third personal against Jonker, third team foul against Sagu here in the half. J.J. Bowling back in there. He had to leave earlier with the blood issue. Ball turned over left side. Geraldo Lane. Horton. Law. Of course, Law picked up two quick fouls and had to go to the bench a while back. Good to see him back out there again for Freed-Hardeman. They need their horses right now. Down two in a dog fight with 13 minutes to go. Bowling to Jonker. Collins attacks back out. There's Jonker back to C.J. Hall. Hall off the screen at Kelly. Lost it, regathered it. Back at Collins. Seven to shoot. Has a screen if he wants it. Just pulls it. Might have been blocked. Either way, J.J. Bowling stayed with it and came up with it.
Shot clock violation.
So the clock reset, even though the ball never got near the rim, and the refs were hip to it. They got the call in on the shot clock violation. And, of course, the argument the other way, and I think he's – respectably making a good argument there for Coach Delton Deal. It wasn't at zero when we shot it. So, you know, tough scenario. Tomlinson over to the right side. There's Law. Three. In and out. No good. Rebound tipped around. There's Bowling. Over the timeline goes Collins. All the way to the rack, off the glass, and good. Four-point game. 12:06 to go. Freed needing an answer. They hadn't had a field goal in a bit here. Back over. Tomlinson. Turning the corner to the elbow. Now back out again. Lane got it to Tomlinson. Hand off. Lax downhill all the way up. Swatted away. Jonker's got the basketball. Next dead ball is the under 12 media. Collins will push the issue, works it back out. There's a travel. That'll get us to the under 12 media. This is the Partner Sports Network presentation of the Battle at the Beach.
I'm a boss, but I do it live. I'm gonna make it toast, cause we still alive. No big, I feel like a pot. Shoot a shot.
47-43, 11-31 to go. Working left, back over to the right now. Freed-Hardeman hasn't had a bucket since Geraldo Lane made a layup at the 16-25 mark. Now over 5 minutes since the last field goal. Horton misses that one. Up and won't drop. Fought for, tipped around, controlled by C.J. Hall going the other way. He's going to help his teammate up and keep his dribble.
It's a new one.
Yeah, I never seen that before. What can C.J. Hall not do? Feeds it into the corner. There's a three. Misses that one going the other way. The drive lays it up too hard off the glass. Thrown ahead to Bowling. Hall. All the way up off the glass. Good.
And one. One.
You're starting to feel like Freed's pressing a bit here.
Trying to get shots too quick and just try to make up the difference in one shot, and you just can't do that. And you just got to – look, plenty of time left. You're only down 6 points at this point right now, so just work your way back in it.
But they are nearly 6 minutes without a shot from the floor.
What you can't have is what just happened on that possession. C.J. Hall working his way out of the phone booth, dribbling against the defender, making his way to the basket and getting the opportunity for the and one.
49-43, 10:38 remaining, and at the free throw line is Hall. Misses back iron, rebound, poked out of bounds, Freed-Hardeman basketball. They'll be thrown in to Quan Lax. C.J. Hall now with 14 points for Sagu. Law got it back over left side, now down to the corner, works it toward the block, that's Lane. He finds Skurlock, hesitation up and a foul, that's four on Yonker. Noah Jonker, rather. And now they put it on Kelly. Noah Jonker said he got him, but the referee said no, Kelly did. That's now three on Kelly. Or is it two? It is two on Kelly. Free throw missed by Skurlock. Just 1 point in the last five, or in the last 6 minutes for Freed-Hardeman. And it'll stay there as he misses both. Rebound by Sagu, going the other way with it. C.J. Hall can't corral it, and there's an unforced turnover.
Noah Bowling back in. Lyric Hall check in. C.J. Hall and Justin Collins check out for Sagu.
Works it over left side. There's Law for three, no good. Rebound brought down by J.J. Bowling. There's a handoff to Alaric Hall. Over the timeline he goes. Backs it back out now, 9:55 to play. Sends it over, deflected, out of bounds. Bowling gets it into Hall. Alaric Hall all the way, kicks it back out. Freed's got it on the steal. Thrown ahead, there's Lane, into the lane, off the glass, and the drought's over. The first bucket for Freed since the 16:25 mark. They cut it to four. Defense! 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 Nearly 7 minutes without a shot from the floor. Working left is Alaric Hall. Jonker. J.J. Bowling. He'll work back over. There's Bowling again. Noah Bowling this time. Two to shoot. All the way. Muscles it up. We got it to go.
What a shot.
Noah Bowling's a magic man. How in the world he even got that shot off, I don't know, let alone make it.
Another backdoor cut.
Oh,
up and
an answer
in
at the other end by Lane. 4 point ball game, 8:49 to go. Bowling to Owens. Big man with a turnaround, won't drop. Taken back down, fed back to him. Hits that second opportunity. Words are hard. Going over the timeline. Thrown ahead to Law. Left wing now. Horton got it over, now back up to Lane. He'll attack, split, kick, Skurlock, three, no. Black iron tipped alive, Owens has it. 6 point deficit for Freed-Hardeman. Sagu trying to make it a three possession game here. Works to the right against Skurlock, back out, hand off. Noah Bowling for three, buried for Noah Bowling. He's got 13. The lead is 9 for Sagu. Freed just needing an answer of some kind here. Lax on the basketball. Attacks, kicks, Lane in the corner against J.J. Bowling. Back out. T3 from right in front of the bench. Just too far out. Tipped out of bounds, and they'll give it to Sagu. Timeout. 7:38 remaining. That's a Freed-Hardeman timeout. I haven't seen a signal on 30 or full here. Let's pause on the Faulkner Sports Network presentation of the Battle of the Beach. Working up the sideline is Alaric Hall. Back out, J.J. Bowling. No good, rebound taken down. Headed the other way, Peyton Law. Fires it ahead, Lax back over to Law. Left side, Tomlinson down in the corner. Geraldo Lane, Barry. 56-50, now you gotta focus on the defensive end if you're Freed-Hardeman. Eight fouls already on him.
For Freed, it has been all Geraldo Lane here the last little bit. Three in their last couple of buckets.
J.J. Bowling works it over right side. That's Alaric Hall now. He's got a screen from Owens. He'll take it toward the baseline. Muscles it back out. Noah Bowling there climbs it over the rim. He's got 15. That's a game high. 8-point game, 6:52 remaining. Over the timeline, we'll go Lax. Works it ahead. Gets the handoff now back to Tomlinson over right side. That's going to be Law. Feeds it to Skurlock. Skurlock backs it back out. Out to Law for three. Missed everything. And Skurlock saved it back in. but it starts the break the other way for Sagu. Alaric Hall over the top, deflected. Freed will steal it. Lead pass. Lane, one bounce. All the way, layup, right hand, good, and an offensive foul. Or did they go and one? They went and one.
They went and one. It was
all right.
Yeah, it's confusing signal from the referee.
Yeah, it was an odd signal as he turned and pointed the other way, but they do go and one there, which is the right call as the defender didn't have his feet. 58-52. And Lane will go to the line to try to cut it to five. That's four fouls on Jonker now.
Geraldo Lane, second leading scorer on this Freed-Hardeman team, shoots 75% from the free throw line.
6:16 remains, 58-52. As Geraldo Lane steps to the line here, he's got 13, that's a team high. So checking out, Jonker Owens and Bowling all out. Kelly back in for Sagu. Bowling not out, correction. Both of the Bowlings on the floor right now, along with both Halls and Kelly. So starting five out there for Sagu. 5-point game, 6:08 to go. There's the attack for C.J. Kelly off the glass and good. 7-point ball game. Thrown ahead to Skurlock. Works it over to Lax. Tomlinson. Now down into the corner. That's going to be Wheat. Back ahead. Skurlock. Got to get it out of there. There's Tomlinson for three. In and out. No good. Skurlock tips it alive. Kelly will come away with it. Three possession lead and the ball for Sagu with 5:26 to go. Hall ahead to Hall. Tries to break Tomlinson down and he's called for the travel. Listen, we got to talk about Tomlinson. The numbers aren't just enormous for him. He's very productive, but his ability to defend down low and up top for a guy his size, yeah, really impressive to me.
It really is, and that was a situation. C.J. Hall was starting to lick his chops, had the matchup he thought that he wanted, and Tomlinson able to shift his feet quick enough and brought that travel.
Deceptively quick for a guy his size. That's the Under 6 Media. Let's pause. Fawner Sports Network presentation of the Battle at Beach. Over the timeline. Working left. That's Wheat with it. Attacks through. Floater goes for J.J. Wheat. Heading to five again with five to play.
Now 8 points for J.J. Wheat.
Bowling sends it
good
to
feed.
Kelly. Couldn't get it to go. 5-point game, a chance to cut it to one possession here. As Horton, Scurlock, all the way to the right.
Blocked
by Kelly and a foul.
Gonna get the foul.
So, third personal on C.J. Kelly.
Scurlock, 11 points on the afternoon, just 1 of 4 from the free throw line.
Yeah, this is the kind of game you start to tell what the legs are like for guys at this time of the day. 4:41 left. Free throws, so much about being able to get the legs under you to shoot them. And Scurlock has done a lot of work both ends of the floor. He's able to make the second. 4-point game. So the foul ends up being a positive for Sagu. There's Alaric Hall. Noah Bowling. Working right. Over the top to Kelly. He's met there by two defenders. Gets it out to Hall. Hall found C.J. Hall. Steps into the three, back iron, no good. C.J. Kelly, rebound, put back good. Freed couldn't keep C.J. Kelly off the glass. And that's now 12 rebounds for Kelly.
Yeah, three Freed-Hardeman defenders there for the rebound. Nobody boxes out Kelly. The length and athleticism right there, that shot blocked.
Let me correct that. 13 rebounds for Kelly. And that's his fourth foul. The battle of the glass going to Sagu, though. 37-27 advantage for Sagu, including 13 boards by C.J. Kelly. But that is Kelly's fourth foul, and Scurlock goes to the line 1-1. And he can't get it to go. And now, 6-point lead with the ball. Freed down to 50% at the free throw line now, 8 out of 16. And a travel. Are they calling a foul on the floor first? Okay. Foul on the floor first. They're going to put it on Quan Lax.
So that will put a Lyric Hall at the free throw line. Lyric Hall yet to score in this ball game, but has 6 assists for Sagu.
Free throw up. Back iron rattles in. One more look at it for Hall. Now a 3-possession game. Make it an 8-point game. 3:33 to go. The road back for Freed-Hardeman looking more tumultuous. Sagu trying to close in on a big win over the number 8 team in the country. Let's pause on the Partner Sports Network presentation of the Battle of the Beach. We'll be right back. 8-point deficit for Freed-Hardeman. Lax works it over the timeline. All the way to the rack, off the glass, and good. He's got 10. Back the other way with it now. Alaric Hall. Freed needing a stop. Those have been hard to come by. Second half, Sagu shooting 46% from the floor in the second half. There's Noah Bowling. Front iron, no good. Tip out right back to C.J. Hall, though. Now they can burn more clock. Sagu. Executing with a 6-point lead. Burning clock. Something they struggled with yesterday with a big lead. And it costs them at Noah Bowling. He did it at the end of the shot clock yet again. 18 for Noah Bowling.
Good patience for Bowling. Understood how much time he had. Got the defender up. Allowed it to go by. Then took that shot.
Horton, Skurlock. All the way. Left-hand layup. Good. Cuts it back to 7 again. That is twice in this second half that Noah Bowling has had the ball in his hand at the very end of the shot clock, and he did not rush it, and he came up with something special with defenders all around him. And Noah Bowling, phenomenal performance for him in this second half especially. 18 points, 3 boards, 2 assists, 2 steals for Noah Bowling.
4 of 8 from beyond the three-point line. Just done a little bit of everything and done everything well for Sagu here this afternoon.
16 for C.J. Hall, 12 points and 13 boards for C.J. Kelly, along with an assist, a steal, and 2 blocks. And for Freed-Hardeman, it's 14 for Hunter Skurlock, 14 for Geraldo Lane, 10 for Quan Lax. And the number 8 team in the country is down 7 with 2:16 to go.
A lot of that's due to some of the shooting of Sagu, specifically from beyond the 3 in stretches. But Sagu's done a very good job defensively on Freed-Hardeman, making everything incredibly difficult for them to even get a good clean look.
Yeah, and one of the things I'll tell you, listen, the difference in the game right now, 7-point difference. Freed is 2 out of 16 from 3. Sagu is 8 out of 21. That's just that's you look at those makes, because Freed's got 25 makes from the floor, and Sagu's got 24. 6 of your 7 points are just coming from the additional points from the made threes. Then you go to the free throw line, 11 out of 13 for Sagu. And 8 out of 16 from Freed. So Freed not shooting it well today in any capacity other than in the paint, where they're dominating 44-20. But the 3-point line has been the great equalizer for Sagu, and they lead by 7. Lyric Hall, the drive all the way up, and a foul on Quan Lax. It'll be 4 on Lax.
Both backcourt starters for Freed-Hardeman now have 4 fouls.
Hall's second makes it a 9-point ball game. There's Lax over the timeline, off the screen, all the way down the lane. Left right hand no good, but a foul. And he landed awkwardly. Frustrated that it didn't go.
Yeah, he's just mad he didn't get the shot to drop.
Emotional damage for Quan Lax rather than the physical damage. 69-60, 1:44 to go. Shout out to our buddy Brandon Campbell, who's the producer for this game. He needs a Red Bull. I can't help it. Shelly Kaiser reaches back out, rooting for Sagos. Has come on Sago finishing. Good to hear from you again, Shelly. Long conversation or long delay here as they wipe up the sweat off the baseline. Quan Lax able to catch his breath. Let's go. 69-60 with 1:44 remaining. Lax has got 10 points. He hasn't been to the free throw line today. 6 boards, 2 assists, 3 steals, and a block. A little bit of everything for Quan Lax in this one. Lax. Free throw up and good. So that'll cut it to 8. One more look coming from Lax. Misses it front iron. Owens will clear the board. Alaric Hall over the timeline. Sagu can burn clock. Freed's got to try to force the issue. Hall. Kick. CJ Hall hesitates, drives. Lost it. Peyton Laws got it, throws it ahead. He lost it coming back the other way to Alaric Hall. Now fired ahead, and Sagu can burn clock again. CJ Hall just falls out of bounds with the ball. So Freed-Hardeman basketball. I think it's just watching. I think the idea of like hold it and burn clock is really hard for CJ Hall, who is ready to score. Coach, I'm here to get buckets. 69-61. That's like both of these last two possessions. CJ Hall has the ball in attack mode and then has to throw on the brakes at the last moment.
As it is, it's a 17th turnover for Sagu in the ball game.
There's Horton. Skurlock, lane opens up, spins back, lays it up left hand, good.
Nice spin in the lane. Saw where the defender was and spun right back the opposite direction.
Two possession game with 53 seconds left. And we had a whistle for some reason. So they adjust the clock to 55.3. Sagu takes a timeout, a 30-second timeout. 6-point game. You got to be sound and disciplined here if you're Freed. You don't have to foul, and you don't have to force anything. But you got to keep them from scoring.
Yeah, stay in front, don't foul. And just as importantly, you've got to watch those backdoor cuts and those types of things coming from Sagu here. You don't want to give up the easy one. Freed will set right back up in this full court pressure.
Bowling gets it in to C.J. Hall, thrown ahead to Alaric Hall. He'll run through traffic, dribble out clock. Lax trying not to foul him. J.J. Weed will get to him. They'll set the trap up in the corner. C.J. Hall with it. Trap comes to him. He loses it, and a foul. Put it on Skurlock. Geraldo Lane. Okay.
Yeah.
That's now 4 or 3 rather on Geraldo Lane. CJ Hall at the line trying to make it a 3 possession ball game. And he does. You can breathe a lot easier now if you're Sagu.
17 points for C.J. Hall.
70-63. missed and then rolls in. So it makes a mo. 8-point game again. Wheat working left now. Deep three from Horton. Drills it. 5-point game, 30 seconds left. Horton from back near the scorer's table somewhere. Bowling fell down.
Say he stepped on the end line. It's going to be Freed-Hardeman basketball.
So a turnover, and is bowling okay? .6 The shot clock no longer a factor in this regulation period. 5-point ball game, the number 8 team in the country trying to find a way to climb out of this deficit. Sagu trying to avoid a crushing comeback loss for the second straight day and finish off what would be a huge resume win for them. I think I called at the beginning of the broadcast, I called Sagu number 22 in the country. I believe they're receiving votes.
Sam won.
But I'm telling you, what we've seen this weekend, results notwithstanding, this looks like a top 25 basketball team to me.
It does. This is a basketball team that can score, that they can defend. They've got length and athleticism. They can play a couple of different ways. I think this is a team that will be dangerous throughout the course of this season for sure.
So Quan Lax with a layup makes it a one-possession ball game. He could cut it to two with this free throw. And he makes it. 24.6 to go in a 2-point game. Noah Bowling to inbound, and he'll take the timeout. Sagu's going to talk about it. And Freed-Hardeman is trying to climb out of the depths again here. And a full timeout. Let's take it with him and prepare for the end of this one. 71-69, 24.6 left to go here at the Battle at the Beach. .71-69, 2-point game, 24.6 left. Fired into Alaric Hall. Trap comes. He's got to get it out of there to Noah Bowling. He'll turn against the defense, throw it ahead. J.J. Bowling dribbles it back out. Very wise decision.
Yes.
There's Alaric Hall, and he'll get fouled.
Him dribbling it back out forces the foul, and now they got to make their free throws here to seal this one up.
You're in the double bonus, though. You make them both. You're back to a two-possession game. Freed's hoping for a miss of some kind.
And for Lax, that's his fifth foul, so he's done. He'll finish with 14 points, 6 rebounds, 2 assists, 3 steals, couple of blocks.
It's a good day at the office
it
for
is.
Quan Lax. Alaric Hall. An opportunity to almost salt it away here for Sagu. Hall sets, and he makes the first 3-point game. 5 points, all of them from right there. For Alaric Hall, and all here in the second half.
Give him six, and it's a four-point game again. Freed needing a quick bucket. Wheat through traffic, kicks. Horton ball fake, feeds it over. Wheat three, too much. Skurlock rebound, putback, lays it in, good. 3.3 to go, and we're back to a two-point game again. Now you're looking for something truly special if you're Freed-Hardeman.
Go for the steal off the inbound real quick, then a foul, then.
And I think you got to do everything you can to make somebody other than Alaric Hall catch that inbound pass.
He's been good at the free throw line here this afternoon, and if you can take the ball out of his hands, you'll feel a little bit better anyway.
When you look at free throw percentages, and of course you're early in the season here, coming into the day, Hall was almost 86%. Actually, let me correct that.
Honestly, your best bet, C.J. Hall, and he still shoots nearly 70%.
You don't want Alaric Hall or Noah Bowling catching that pass on the inbound. Noah Bowling is perfect at the free throw line this year on 14 attempts. Alaric Hall is now 18 out of 20. So, you know, C.J. Hall is probably your best bet, but it's hard to draw a play up to force the ball to one guy.
It is.
You got free throw shooters abound here for Sagu. It's a thing they do really well. On the season, they're at almost 79% coming into today, and they're 89.5% today. So Freed needs the steal. Bowling. And you're going to get a foul call on Wheat. That keeps the clock from moving at all. And they're hoping for the miss. But Alaric Hall will step to the line.
Got to have at least one miss.
Hall has not been obliging in that category. If he makes both, it's largely academic here. So Freed. Tomlinson will check in. Wheat will check out. That was the fifth foul on J.J. Wheat. His day done. 8 points, three boards, an assist, and a couple of blocks, and Alaric Hall makes that one. Now 7 points on a perfect day at the free throw line. One more for Hall makes it a two-possession game and a four-point game. Misses. Freed's got a chance, but they got to make a three to send it to overtime. Horton heaves and misses off the shot clock. So Freed-Hardeman had a chance at it. Horton may have picked his dribble up a little too early and couldn't really get a good look at it.
Yeah, well, at that point, they'd wasted enough time of that 3 seconds trying to get the ball back out. Horton kind of had to shoot it there to have any kind of chance to get the ball up. And just a difficult shot to make from that point at that in that spot on the floor.
74-71. Sagu avoids another cardiac defeat.
Yeah.
And it's more than that, though. I think you got to say for them, they played an excellent ball game.
They did.
And they played an excellent ball game yesterday, but the closing moment of the game resulted in a loss. When you look at 80 minutes of play here for them over the course of 2 days, you feel good about 79 of them.
Right. And it's a situation where in that game yesterday, Sagu quick shot in the second half, and that really allowed Florida College to work their way back in. In this game, they weren't so much trying to get that quick shot. They were looking for a better shot offensively, and they were taking some of their time. They're still trying to get out in that transition when they could, but they weren't forcing that issue the entire stretch of the ball game.
So Sagu's going to go to 4-2.
They'll play again next Thursday when they travel to Chickasaw, Oklahoma, to take on the University of Science and Arts. For Freed-Hardeman, they'll drop to 5-2. They play again in Kingsport, Tennessee at the show this weekend against West Virginia Tech. 18 apiece for C.J. Hall and J.J. Bowling, 12 for C.J. Kelly. 18 for Hunter Skerlock, 14 for Quan Lax, 14 for Geraldo Lane, for David Turner, Brandon Campbell, Jeremy Smith.
For myself, I guess. For Brandon Campbell, David Turner, I am Jeremy Smith. And, hey, how about Grayson Plunkett? God bless him.
He did something.
I forgot he's here. He's sorting lunch out now. So this has been the Faulkner Sports Network presentation of the Battle at the Beach. We're back here in just a little bit with Faulkner and Texarkana. Good night. God bless you.